where can you go to make a difference in the world?
I wanted to, I guess, do something that was applicable, that would really help people.
There's people in the world that don't even have access to like basic human needs, like housing, water, and you know, basic food.
To address the grand challenges of this world.
Whether it's something with food, which everybody needs, or water, or the environment, which everybody depends on.
Many of today's students want to make a difference in the world. And the ones that choose agriculture and biological engineering in particular have seen a way that they can do that.
It makes me excited to know that ABE and myself are located right in the middle and the heart of these problems and trying to attack them and deal with them.
The Department of Agricultural and Biological Engineering at Purdue University.
The work we do here matters.
The ABE, the Ag and Biological Engineering Department, is one of the best kept secrets on Purdue's campus in the School of Engineering.
A lot of people talk about chemi, and a lot of people talk about, you know, aeronautical engineering, and those are the big ones.
We're south of State Street, we're kind of hidden.
I originally started out in civil engineering because I thought, you know, I want to do environmental type work, and I thought that was the place I needed to be. And then I had a friend who was a fifth year senior in ABE and kind of opened the door to that. I didn't realize that it was even an option. I'd never heard of ABE before. And I went over and visited the department, and it was just, it felt like family.
What's great about ABE, it's a small family, but with a lot of opportunity.
The coolest thing about this department is all the hands-on experience you get and the one-on-one attention that you get from their professor.
If you're going down the hallway, a professor is actually going to say hi and know your name and recognize you in your classes.
We have very small class sizes, 30 people maximum in these classes. Our professors are available all the time. You can knock on their door and say, hey, I'm having trouble with this, I'm having trouble with that.
I mean, it was very small. People were very friendly. You weren't just kind of a person in, you know, in the crowd.
Yeah, it's a small program, but that's part of the reason I came here, because when you're in a small program, you matter more.
I recommend everybody at least look into it and just discover some of the things that ABE has to offer.
It just gives you that personal interaction that not only helps you in your career and networking, but that helps you in just getting through school.
So whether you want to go into the agriculture side of things and you want to work with machines or food processing, or whether you want to be with what I'm doing, which is the biology and biomems, you know, designing small chips that can interface with living things.
One of the neat things about the ABE department is it's basically every other engineering field with an agricultural application.
We have so many different sub-disciplines from food processing, environmental,
machines,
bioenergy,
biological things,
air quality, water quality,
nanotechnology, you name it, it's done in this department.
Students can really grow at ABE.
I think that the kind of students who often choose agricultural and biological engineering are first those who want to make a difference in the world, because that's really the focus of most of what we do.
Agricultural and biological engineering is a field you could go into where you could actually make a change.
One of the classes that we took was advanced hydrology, and that was a great class. So I noticed in my own life experiences how water has impacted. So when I started taking classes in ABE, I was able to solve some of these problems.
It makes me excited to know that ABE and myself are located right in the middle and the heart of these problems and trying to attack them and deal with them.
Yeah, so it's very important to me in my education to be learning skills that I can and already have used to improve the world.
I actually came from a different background. I came from a physics background. I was studying that and I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really neat. But I wanted to just, I guess, do something that was applicable, that would really help people make differences in their own lives and improve the quality of life for other people.
I have been able to learn real skills, and through my internships and that, I've been able to bring them directly to companies. I've also helped the research community. So basically, ABE and the people within it are very adept at helping you achieve those goals.
I think it is exciting because I wanted to do something that was technically challenging, and engineering is that, but it's helping the community and the environment.
Well, I was excited to start out in agriculture and biological engineering because it's a really neat program, very diverse, and a lot of real-world application. You see people working on tractors and all kinds of grain and food processing, all the way to what we do, which is more environmental work.
Your exhaust is the main problem that we encountered a problem with. We had to come up with a way to make it quieter, and an application like that could and is being used in industry at the moment now.
We tend to be a very applied department. As we solve engineering problems, like all of the engineering fields, we use the same tools, the mathematical tools, computer tools, etc. But most of ours have a specific application in that someone wants to use these results to solve the world's grand challenges.
What we're testing is a hydraulic system that is able to recover energy. So it's like your Toyota, like a Toyota Prius. When you step on the brakes of a Prius, the kinetic energy of the car moving down the road is transferred into electrical power and stored in batteries. This system tries to do the exact same thing, except in the hydraulic realm.
The professors in ABE, you know, at least the ones that I know, have always pushed their students to try new things.
One of the reasons I came to ABE was the fact that they have a good reputation, so they work with a lot of government agencies, industry, and working on real-world research that actually gets implemented fairly recently or while you're still working on it.
In ABE, I've worked on a project that involves specifically siting constructed wetlands, wetlands that you will construct to treat runoff coming off agricultural fields, and that taking out that nitrogen will eventually help downstream in the Gulf of Mexico.
My research is exciting because it's incorporating all the fundamentals of engineering and then applying it in a real world situation.
The students really get a win-win situation with this project. Not only do they learn the engineering skills that we want to teach them, just good fundamental design, what it takes to have something hold up for a particular environment. They design it on the computer, they build it, they predict its performance, have to pick the gear ratios. But then there's also a service learning and a human aspect to the vehicle where the application of there really makes a big difference in the lives of the people.
So we put this tower up on the edge of a cornfield. It's run off a 12-volt battery because there are no outlets out in the cornfields. It's recharged by the solar panel, and it collects environmental data and then shoots it up through a satellite signal to a computer server somewhere so I can sit there on my computer in my office and see what's going on my different research sites across the state.
Knowing its ultimate application, I think you realize, you know, the importance of the work, and you realize, you know, how much of a time crunch you're in to get these things done, because this is where we are on, you know, the edge of technology right now.
We're delivering a project, whether it be a tangible project or a design for something that we'll pass on to an NGO or another institution in the field that can implement it and ideally impact people's quality of life.
Job placement is very good in ABE. I believe we have a 99% job placement.
This past year, several of our graduates got hired on with CAT, and then there were several that got hired on with John Deere's. And as you know, they're both really big companies.
Those companies are Caterpillar, John Deere, CNH.
Parker has hired on several of our applicants as well.
We also have water companies, companies that are doing environmental studies.
Students in the environmental and natural resources engineering area usually either work for a conservation agency or an environmental agency like the Department of Natural Resources.
The companies that know us, that know of ag and biological engineering students, they eat us up every year.
The fact that we have big companies like that coming and recruiting our people is just shows the quality of education here.
So every time, you know, the department says, here are our graduates, those companies are right there first in line to say, we want this person, we want that person. Once they get that first ABE graduate in there, that company will come back reliably year after year and hire graduates.
Where can you go to make a difference in the world? To address the grand challenges of this world? the Department of Agricultural and Biological Engineering at Purdue University.
The work we do here matters.